says, no man is permitted to touch a leper, or otherwise the man becomes unclean. But in this case, we discover that when that leper cried for mercy, Jesus broke protocol and touched him. I pray for somebody under the sound of my voice. Because you are here this morning, heaven will break protocol for you in Jesus' name. Because you are here this morning, the hearts will break protocol for you in Jesus' name. What does the word sure mean? The word sure means certain. The word sure, it means certain. It means settled. It means fixed. It means unchangeable. I pray for you that God's mercy towards you, they shall be sure and unchangeable in Jesus' name. It is important to know that not all mercies are sure. Not all mercies are sure. How do we know this? Our Father and the Lord shared the example of the man called Saul. Saul was the first king that was appointed. But when he went into sin and he was confronted, he never asked for forgiveness. But there was a man who killed somebody, David. David killed a whole man. He took the man's wife, killed the husband. Was his own sin greater than that of Saul? The sin of Saul was go there and destroy the Amalekites. He went there, he didn't destroy the sheep. He didn't destroy the bull. He kept the good things. He destroyed the things that he believed were worthless. The sin of David was far greater by human standard than the sin of Saul. But David was always a man who was always humble. The message of God for you and your household shall be permanent in Jesus' name. Why was David such a special man? Why was David such a special man? In fact, in my own notes, I amended it. Our Father in the Lord said, "Why? What was special about David?" But in my own notes, I put, how can I enjoy the sure mercies of David? And I think that is one of the things that every one of us must leave this place with this morning. What things that you must do to enjoy the sure mercies of David? Number one, genuine repentance. Genuine repentance. Once you repent before God genuinely, not pretending, not eye service. The Bible speaking in the book of 1 Corinthians, it says that godly sorrow worketh repentance. When you are genuinely sorry, then you will enjoy the sure mercies of David. Number two thing that you must do is that you must be humble. The Bible says in the book of James that God resists the proud, but he gives more grace to the humble. Once you are humble, you will enjoy the sure mercies of David. Number three, David was always grateful for every little thing that God does for him. You see David expressing gratitude. When God made him a king, he expressed gratitude. Even when his wife was speaking against him, he still expressed gratitude. When God forgave him his sin, he expressed gratitude. When he told God he wanted to build a house for God, and God said, you cannot build for me, but your son will build. David still expressed gratitude. He said, Father, for you to have considered that me, I will have my children to reign after me. David knew that the first king's son did not reign after him. And so God gave him the opportunity that his child will reign after him. And he was always so grateful. I pray for somebody under the sound of my voice. For the remaining days of your life, you will find it easy to show gratitude in Jesus' name. Number four, David was a soul winner. Everywhere you find David, he was always talking about God. Even before he became king, after he became king, he was always a soul winner. I want to encourage every one of us under the sound of my voice this morning. This is not a time to be distracted by your neighbor and be laughing and gisting. This is a time for you to ensure that all these five things, you have them. Are you a soul winner? Since the beginning of this year, we are now in the month of June. Have you ever told anybody that Jesus is Lord? Have you ever said to somebody or to your neighbor or to your friend in school or to your colleague in the workplace or in the shop or where you are doing your business that Jesus loves you? Have you ever invited anybody to the presence of God to church? Until you do those things, you do not qualify for the sure mercies. The last but not the least was the fact that David was dedicated to God 100%. How many of us will really say that we are dedicated to God 100%? Are we giving him 40%? Are we giving 50%? Some of us are giving 80. Some of us are giving 90. 90 is great. Yes, you will score A. But David was a man who gave 100%. He gave everything that he had. Are you sacrificing your time for God? Are you sacrificing your resources for God? I want to pray with you that as you begin to observe these five things, the sure mercies of David will follow you all the days of your life in Jesus' name. Can you please rise on your feet again and say, Father, Teach me humility so that I can enjoy the sure mercies of David. Lift up your voice and cry to God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask that you teach me humility. Teach me humility so that I can enjoy the sure mercies of David. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The sure mercies of David are generational. Sure mercies of David are generational, which means your children and the children after you will enjoy it. You will lift up your voice to the heaven and say, my father, for me and my generation, let us enjoy your sure mercies. Lift up your voice, lift up your voice, lift up your voice, lift up your voice. For me and my generation, let us enjoy your sure mercies. For me and my generation, oh God, let me enjoy your sure mercies. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Shall we please put our hands together for Jesus as we take our seats?
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Testimony time. Testimony time. If you know you have testimony in the house, can I see your hand up? If you know God has been faithful to you, most especially in the past month, number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, six, and seven. Okay, let's just, number eight, make it sharp. Just go straight to the point and make it sharp. Just tell us what God has done for you and how grateful you are. Just make it sharp. So number one, please come forward. Number one, please come forward, sir. Number two, get ready. Number three, get ready. All testifiers, please step forward. All testifiers, please step forward. If you know you have to, you have raised up.
I don't even know. Daddy, let me sing that song, please.
Oshubarere, oh, Oshubarere, oh, Obatauri, Tari, se oware, Oshubarere, oh.
Some people will think I don't know what I'm doing, but they won't know. I'll just hide myself. Due to who I am, I don't need to cast myself. But our God, he has been good. I don't see him. I don't know him. But he has been so good to me. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Testifier number two. All testifiers, please.
Praise God. Eledumare Arubojo Onye di kagi, onye di kagi, ele du mare, arubo ojo, onye di kagi, onye di kagi. Onye, onye, arubo ojo, onye di kagi.
Praise God. I am going to be 1 year old as a mother. By 19th of June, Hallelujah. I'll be 1 year old. Praise God for his faithfulness.
Please come forward. Next person, please.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. I thank God for the salvation of my soul. I thank you for my family. I thank you for my children, my husband. I thank you for every household of God. I give God for preserving us to this day. I say thank you. I thank you for the children's anniversary. The Lord make it a successful one. I give God the glory. I give you honor. I give you praise. I say thank you. Before the anniversary, there's an accident that happened last month. Second week, I thank God because the Lord see me through. It not allow evil to happen to me and my family. The Lord protects me. He guides me. Even with the load that I'm carrying, the Lord was able to lift me up from that accident and drop me back to that position. I give God the glory because I am alive. I am alive to be at the to be the witness of the anniversary. I say thank you, Lord, in Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. I give God all the glory for his protection over me and my family. I want to celebrate the name of God because he didn't let me run to the hand of the ritualist. I will be brief about it. It happens that May 17th, I have a meeting I have to attend at Bega. So the people, they were coming from Highland, but their driver is not around. The driver was not around that time. So they called somebody that, please help us with the driver to drive us down to mainland. So when they are coming, we're supposed to meet a beggar. They don't call me that. They have already branched an Alawusa that the driver will come and pick me. But this is the driver. You have already given our numbers to the driver. Your pictures, the driver have it. And this is the car that the driver is coming with. But to the glory of God, I was standing there. I didn't see anybody. And immediately I called my husband and I said, they said the driver is coming to pick me. My husband said, don't wait again. They are not coming. They are sending driver. Don't bother yourself. I said, let me wait a little. If I didn't see the driver, I will leave. Then after the 3 hours standing in the sun, I didn't see the driver. I left. But when the driver was coming, they have already dialed my number on the driver's number. Then when you get there, you call the person. But to my surprise, the driver called my husband. But it's not my husband that is standing in the sun. You called my husband at home. My husband said, you are stupid. Why are you calling me? You're supposed to call my wife. Why are you calling me? He said, I didn't even see the number again. The number they gave me, they dialed it, but I didn't see it on the phone again. That's why I have to call you, the husband. And my husband said, you are already late. Standing there for 3 hours is not easy. But later, I was furious. I was angry. What is the meaning of this nonsense? But I don't know that God saved me from the hand of the ritualist. So I want to celebrate the name of the Lord, because at night around 9 o'clock, they called me and said, Mrs. Olainka, where are you? I said, I'm at home. Then where is the driver and the car? I said, driver? I didn't see driver. They were supposed to come 3 o'clock. I didn't see it, so I left there. So after 30 minutes again, they called. They said, they have already tracked the car. The car is in Shaki. That the car did not go. The car went to Shaki to pick. He picked some people from Lagos, 6 people to Shaki. But last week they called us, they said they met the car and the driver with 15 heads that he has already cut off. So I want to celebrate the name of the Lord. I want to thank God because in his fullness parish, he answered our prayer. Because that very day, that spirit told me, I am the dependable wings of protection. So I want to celebrate the name of the Lord, that today we are not standing for my enemy.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. I want to bless the name of the Lord for the salvation of my soul and for my entire family. I want to thank him for journey mercy, for his faithfulness, for all the plans that he has been helping me. And I want to thank him for adding a year to my and that of my daughters on. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You be God, you know be man, no. Ibu chimo, you know be man, no. Alpha and Omega, you be God. You be God, oh. You be God, you know be man, no. I want to thank God for the salvation of my life and my family. I came to this Lambe I'm going to 3 years. I'm a full Roman Catholic. But I'll be going to different redeemed church. But when I step into this church, I saw that there is God in this church. My mom came day before yesterday, and I told her that there is one redeemed church. I'll be coming to this place, and this redeemed church, there is God, the man of God. God called him. Since when I come to this church, oh God, the testimony I want to give today, I don't know how to say, but I know that there is God. God will be good to my husband and myself and my family. When the man of God was praying for the fruit of the womb, I was touching my womb, praying behalf of my senior sister. She got married 2020. I said, God, you will do it for her. You will give her that fruit of the womb. And she called me one night. And she said, my junior sister, I'm pregnant. I said, glory be to God. I said, there is God in this church. There is God in this foolish parish. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I want to sing in my language today. Mesuake Venetians and their bronco book. A young yarang yang kukum. Asuake Venetian, I know I couldn't do. Bonsai, mamma, canadi, yara. Bonsai, mam. Bonsai, mam. Bonsai, mamma, cabadi, dara. Bonsai, mam. Bonsai, mam. Bonsai, mamma, cabadi. Mesuake Venetians and their bronco. Hey, my yara yang yang kukum. Praise the Lord. I really thank God very, very much. I do not even have enough to thank God for sustaining my life, my family, my children. Upon what we are passing through is always in the boat with us. I thank him very, very much. Because even today, he has added another 1 year to my age.
Hallelujah.
My children are all well and happy. We are all fine. So I thank God and I praise his holy name forever and ever. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to bless the name of the Lord for his faithfulness upon my life. Tomorrow will make it a year that we come to Lambeth with nobody, no family. I want to thank God. Since I stepped my foot into this church, God has been so faithful in my life and that of my family. Where we were before, we are always having headache, all this kind of thing. But since we step here, we have never used 1 naira paracetamol. We've been so healthy. God has been so faithful. He has been so marvelous. May his name be highly exalted. I want to thank you, Daddy, Mommy. God bless you. All the people that I meet here, we are all one family. God bless you all. I have this song that says, no one knows like I know what you done for me. That's why I praise you the way I do. Nobody knows like I know what you done for me. That's why I praise you the way I do.
Your God, your church, your Sunday, your time, your person, your God. Jesus, hear me.
He is actually thanking God for his life, and he said he's always coming to church on Mondays, on Tuesdays, on Thursdays, and he prayed for everyone in the church. God will answer our prayer in Jesus' name.
I'll put you in front of my melody. You are all that matters.
You are all that matters. I'll make room for two. You and I, Jesus. You are all that matters. You are all that matters. Oh, hey, oh, hey. You are all that matters. Oh, hey, oh, hey. You are all that matters. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let the living soul praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to thank God for the gift of life. I want to thank God for the salvation of my soul. You don't know why I was singing that song. I remembered when I was in labor, when I was giving birth to my beautiful daughter, Star. I was singing that song. I was in pain. I was singing that song over and over again. I said, yes, you can do this, God. I was singing all over and over again until I heard the cry of my baby. I said, I put you in front. In front of my melody. You are all that matters. You are all that I'll make room for two. I'll make room for two. You and I, Jesus. You are all that matters. You are all that matters. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I also want to thank God for adding another year to my husband's life. Praise
Hallelujah.
The Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
I want to firstly thank God. And I thank our daddy and our mommy. May God be with you. And may God continue to bless you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
My first testimony, I thank God for the life of my son. God add another year to his year this month. I give glory to the Almighty God. Since when I lost his father, the boy was in 6 months. They have not yet admitted him for hospital. I really thank God for God. What I've done.
Hallelujah.
He's a wonderful God. My second testimony, I'm doing the dedication of my daughter today.
Praise the Lord.
I thank God because God was really there for me. I registered the mother in the Redeemer Hospital and she has been there. So the day of her delivery, she didn't tell me anything. Her husband now called me that, mommy, go and check your daughter. When I get there, I say, Ima, what's your problem? She said, it's like I want to poo-poo. I said, this is not a matter of poo-poo. I call a bag to took her to the Redeemer Hospital. She was there from that Tuesday morning, labor. I get there in the night. We did navigate together with nurses there. Nothing. And I entered the room. I saw that Adeboye calendar and Mommy Adeboye. I lie down on it. I was crying. I said, Daddy, you know me, I'm a widow. I don't have anybody, but I have God. When I have you, I have everything. I pray and pray and pray. Nothing. Later, that midnight, they called another doctor to come and check on her. When the doctor came, he tried all his best, all he can do. He said, Mommy, continue to pray because I have tried my best. Nothing come up. I begin to cry, running up and down. God, I know you can do it. They tried. The doctor told me that if you waited till 5 o'clock, that's Wednesday morning, she'd not deliver. Mommy, maybe it will be another thing. No. By then, my body was shaking. That God, where will I see money? Don't let this thing be another story for me. So she was there. That around that 5:30. I carry my Bible, I begin to pray. I cry, I pray on pure water. I take it to the labor room, I give it to her. I say, Immaculate. She say, Ma, I say, do you have faith in God? She say, yes. I say, sorry. I know you are in pain, but my God will do it. So when the doctor wants to come in the morning, he came with Venza. I say, hey, what's it for me? Doctor, Venza, no pay wa. Where will I see money? For Venza, doctor. He took us. So his hospital, When we get there, it's tested. She said, "Mommy, come inside." I said, "Doctor, please, don't let me come inside. Just do what you can do." He said, "Mommy, come and see what caused the delay delivery." I said, "Doctor, if I look at this, I don't see anything, yo. So don't let me see anything. Try your best." She said, "Mommy, you have two options." He said, "The first option, as you are praying, if God help you, I will collect 50,000 naira. But I didn't wish for the second option for you, because that one will cost you 2+. So when he looked at me, he see my leg that was shaking. He said, "Mommy, hold your faith. I know you are weak already, but hold your faith." So I now leave them. They said I should enter the labor room. I said, "Doctor, don't let me die there. Don't let me enter there." I now go outside the hospital, inside the compound. I sit down there. One dog came. The dog was licking my leg, licking everywhere. I don't even know what to do. I was just saying, "Baba Adeboye, do this thing. Don't let me put to shame. Do it. Before you know it, between 30 minutes, I was hearing, mommy. I said, "Kilo today, oh, why are you calling mommy?" They said, "Doctor is calling you." I said, Tell doctor to not call me. Say, "Mommy, it's your baby now." I said, "Why is it? See your baby? Ah, God, you have did this. Praise God, now put me to shame." I said, "You have done this my life again. God of the Adeboye, don't put me to shame. Father, I thank you. I give all the glory. I give all adoration. Brethren, help me to shout a seven sound hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Actually, where I sat there, something kept telling me that don't be ungrateful, child. And firstly, I just want to thank God for the God of this commission. It happened last week that I actually want to change a bulb in my house. And that is not the first time. But I tried to put the bulb. Before I know, all the light went off. I was like, "What is happening?" I went to the kitchen direct. Before I got in there, I see there is a fire already. So I was perplexed. What is happening? I don't even know what to do at that moment. I just carry water inside. Immediately the light went off. My wife was asking me what is happening. He came to meet me at the kitchen. Say, "What is happening?" So I want to thank God that there is no fire outbreak in my house. So I give God all the glory. To my surprise, when I called the electrician to come and immediately I called the electrician that there's something wrong with my electrical in my house. He should come and help me to check. When the guy came, the guy climbed up. He said, "Oga, say all the wire of this house are burnt." I say, "Wow, see, God is great." So that is my testimony.
Praise the Lord. All testifiers, can we be on our feet as our pastor pray for the testifiers?
Everlasting Father, the King of Glory, we thank you for all your children that you have done one thing or the other for. Thank you for safe delivery. Thank you for divine protection. Thank you for provision. Thank you for health. We thank you for as many also who have testimonies but could not get up and share this. Thank you for birthday celebration. Thank you for wedding anniversaries. Father, we ask for all these testimonies that they will be permanent in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. It is time for us to give our offering. And tithers in the house, package your tithes. And after paying your offering, kindly come front and pay your tithes. And also the covenant partner, those that are partnering with Jesus Christ in this mission. If you know you want to support Christ for one thing or the other, for the building of this church and one thing, please kindly come front and pay your covenant partner offering. So choir, please give us a danceable song while we pay our offering.
Who is greater than Jehovah, Lord divine? No, there is no one greater.
No one greater.
Who is greater than the overlord divine?
There is no one greater than you, my Lord.
Excellent.
Father, in Jesus' name. Father Jehovah, we thank you for what you have been doing. Daddy, and also we use this offering as a point of contact to our finances. Father, our pockets will never run dry in Jesus' name. Father, we'll continue to live in abundance in the name of Jesus. So that the next time we'll give, Father, we'll give more than this in the name of Jesus. And all glory and honor in our life will be ascribed to you alone. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Let's pray for the titles now and also the partner covenants. Father Lord, we thank you for your children. You've given the grace to give your tithe. Father Lord, I pray you bless them in return in Jesus' name. They've obeyed your word, Daddy. I pray you in Jesus' name. They will flourish in the mighty name of Jesus, and your name in their life will be glorified. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Praise the Lord.
Can we please go back to our seats while we take our seats briefly as we listen to the following announcement. We are about to begin the Thanksgiving proper. It is important that I inform us of the order. The way we'll do the Thanksgiving, because we have baby dedication, we'll do the baby dedication first. We'll do the baby dedication first. After baby dedication, while the mother of the baby is still in front, we will call on those who are celebrating their birthdays in the month of June and wedding anniversary. After the birthdays and wedding anniversary, we are going to be calling on, don't worry, sir, we are going to be calling on every one of us, the general Thanksgiving. We'll be doing that. So that's the order of the Thanksgiving. We already have our guest minister in the house. Osana David is in the house. Can somebody put his or her hands together for Jesus? Please, I want to plead with you. We thought that we'll be rounding up the service by 11:30, but Daddy Gio came in about 20 minutes late. Daddy Gio usually takes the message by 9:15, but today it didn't start until like 9:40. So we have to make adjustments because of that. So our service may not end by 11:30, but I have no doubt that before 12, God helping us, we'll be rounding up the service. Please, let's listen to the following announcements. The first thing we are going to be doing this morning, I'm going to mention some names. We are going to be praying for some people. In this church, we are seeing a replica of what was happening in Acts of the Apostles. I remember exactly on Monday, while I was praying, that the Lord told me to pray for these people. And what was happening in the church in Acts of the Apostles? The Bible said that every man brought everything that they had, and they all used it in common. And there was nobody in the church that lacked anything. One of the things that we have observed in the past few weeks is that everyone has been contributing one thing or the other, and there has been no lack. I thought somebody was going to clap for Jesus. Sister Ganiat, please, can you rise on your feet? Sister Oluwadarasimi, please, wherever you are, please rise on your feet. Sister Oluwada, please, if I didn't mention your name, please, can you be seated? I want people to recognize these people that are mentioning their names. If I didn't mention your name, please, can you please sit down? Sister Oluwadarasimi, please pay attention. Sister Oluwadamilare, Sister Oluwadamilare. Brother Matthew Aladejare, Brother Idowu. I know Brother Idowu is surprised. Please rise on your feet, sir. Rise on your feet. Please, all the ministers, Brother Lanri Alimi, Sister Yinka Alimi, Sister Apostle Adiroba. Yes, the three of you. Please rise on your feet. I'm going to tell you some of the things that these people have done. I want to believe that I've not forgotten any other name. Those were the names that I wrote down in the course of the... Brother Paul, Ayeme Fuller. Yes, Brother Paul, Ayeme Fuller. All these people that you see standing have done one outstanding thing or the other. Covenant partners in the house, please, can you also rise on your feet? It is an opportunity to also pray for you. If you are a covenant partner and you have been faithful, please, can you rise on your feet? No matter the amount of the vow that you have been using, covenant partners, please rise on your feet. Covenant partners, please, let's put hands together for Jesus. I'm going to be starting with the covenant partners. These people have made a vow unto God that every month they will be given a certain amount of money for the support and the growth of the church. After service, please, I want to encourage you to please go into the children department. You will see that there is a lot of changes that have taken place in the course of the week. The only delay that we have is with the doors. As that this week, what we planned that we're going to be doing on Thanksgiving is that we would have fixed the doors to the usher's office, fixed the doors to the chair, to the pastor's office, and also fixed all the electrical appliances or the wiring for all the children's classes. And now, to the glory of God, the electrical wiring for all the children's classes, pastor's classes, and the usher's office have already been done. Please, can we put our hands together for Jesus? We have one of the doors now. We are expecting the other door. By the time you come next Sunday, we would have fixed those doors in the pastor's office. For Sister Oluadarasimi and Sister Ganiat, you see, everybody can give something. These two young sisters, last Sunday when we were having Children's Sunday, the two of them gave gifts. They gave pencil to all the children that we have here. Please, if you are celebrating Jesus, you can do better than that. Everybody has something to give. Don't always say, I don't have. If these young ladies could give pencil, and all your children went back home and they went with pencil, but it's also young children like this that gave. I remember when they came to me 2 weeks ago and said, Pastor, we want to give something. I said, whatsoever you are giving, make sure it's more than 80, because we are expecting 80 children. And then they organized pencil, 100 pencils. They gave all the children we still have left over. Please, can we celebrate Jesus for them? I also want to celebrate all the ministers. The refreshment that the children ate last week Sunday was provided for by the ministers. Please, can we celebrate Jesus for them? That is in addition to their normal offering, covenant partners that they give. Everything you see happening in this place is because of the covenant partners. It's the covenant partners. They are the ones doing it. Several months ago, our brother Ozana David came here to minister and said the sound was not good. Covenant partners raised a lot of money. We also made pledges of 5,000. How many of us made pledges? If you are around, please, can you also rise on your feet? You made a pledge of 5,000 and you have fulfilled that vow. Please, can you rise on your feet also? The Almighty God will also honor you. We thank God we now have the new instruments. The first day we brought those musical instruments, we could not use power here. Once we switch on the equipment and the fan, the generator will go off. So we now add another challenge. We now needed a bigger generator. For the kind of generator that we expected to now have, would cost us $250,000. We have just raised $350,000 for musical instruments, musical equipment, speakers, mixer, slave. And now you tell people again to bring $250,000. But God laid it in the heart of one of our brothers. He brought his own generator from his house and dropped it in church. Brother Matthew Aladejari, the Almighty God, we honor you in Jesus' name. That generator has been in this church since that day. That was like 2 months ago. The generator has always been here. You always meet it in church. Then somebody saying that, why did you call Brother Idowu? We had to call Brother Idowu. I was watching online. We had to be at the area headquarters because of the inauguration. We had to be there early. And this brother just joined us about a month ago. And he was the one who prayed for all our children here. He prayed for all our children. Please, let's celebrate Jesus for him. Here we recognize everybody that contributes something. Because what that thing that you are contributing is important. The pastor can't do everything. The ministers can't do everything. The workers can't do everything. Everybody is important. Tell your neighbor, say, you are very important. Turn to the other side and tell your neighbor on the other side, you are very, 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 very important. So there's something everybody can contribute. Thank you for praying for our children. God will also pray for your own children too in Jesus' name. There's a prayer that God said I should pray for you. Please, with all eyes closed and all heads bowed. Father, I lift up this, your children, into your hand who have made. Sister Oluada Milari, have I called Sister Oluada Milari? Yes. Sister Oluada Milari, let me mention what she did. When the children came in last Sunday, she made a band for all of them. Every single one of them. All the female. Every single one of them. Now, let's go to the prayer. Father, we thank you for every one of these, your children, that you have used one way or the other. You told me on Monday that I should pray specifically for them, that thou shalt not muzzle the ox that treaded out the wheat, that the laborer is worthy of his wages. You said anyone that has forsaken houses, forsaken money, forsaken their time on this earth for the sake of your kingdom shall in no wise receive on this earth a hundredfold, and in the world to come, eternal life. Daddy, I pray for every one of your children that are standing this morning. Begin to release a hundredfold upon them in Jesus' name. For every sacrifice that they have made, release a hundredfold unto them in Jesus' name. And much more we pray, O God, that they will not miss your kingdom in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Please, let's put our hands together for Jesus as they take their seats. We appreciate you. God recognizes you. The announcements now. There will be Holy Communion today. Holy Communion will take place today at place of his dwelling area headquarters. The time is 5 p.m. Please, I want to encourage, the same way I'm seeing this number, all of us must be at the area headquarters. All of us must be at the area headquarters. You people were wonderful during the inauguration. I was just seeing his fullness all over the place. His fullness all over the place. The same thing, last communion service. And this one again, that is our custom. People must know anywhere we get to that people have come. People must know because you are royalty and you are special. Please let us be there. Place of his dwelling, number 20, Abanishe. On your way towards Matogun, you will see the street, Abanishe Street. Please be there by 5 p.m. Once you are born again, you qualify to take Holy Communion. When we become area headquarters, we'll be sharing communion here. But for now, we are still a parish, so we'll do it over there. Number two announcement is that Believer's Class takes place immediately after the service. What is Believer's Class? If you have attended this church two Sundays in a row, then you must do Believer's Class so that we know you are a member of the church. Let us teach you the rudiments of the Christian faith. That was what they were doing in Acts of the Apostles chapter 2. They met every day, breaking bread and teaching the scripture, sharing scripture. Let us teach you the word of God. And after 3 months, in August, we are having another water baptism. We don't joke with water baptism in this place. We do it 3 times a year. We do it in Easter, we do it in August, and we do it in December. So if you don't do this one, if you don't join this class and do it in August, until December. And I want you to be part of those people that will be doing in August. So the Almighty God will bless you. It's just for about 30 minutes after service, and then you are through. Then you go through all this teaching. We will give you a certificate of parable interpretation. After you have, we are looking at 38 parables. 38 parables are what we are studying. 38 parables. After we finish teaching you those 38 parables, we will now give you a certificate of interpretation of parables. Anywhere you go to, you'll be showing people the certificate. I can interpret parable. I can interpret parable. So it's something that people will recognize. Please, we want to encourage you. Please make sure you are there on Tuesday, 6:30 to 8. Then on Thursday, we are going to be starting our training weekend. Thursday is supposed to be teaching and prayer. Please also be here by 6:30. By 7:30, we'll be through. Then next week, Sunday, we'll be having the grand finale. We'll be doing Thanksgiving. And we'll also be rejoicing. The Almighty God will bless us in Jesus' name. For the young adults and youths, please, there will be a brief meeting immediately after the service. Please, I want to encourage you to please wait. We are taking all these announcements now so that once we start Thanksgiving, nothing will hold us. It's only dancing galore. Please, all the youths, they also reminded that the Provincial Youth Conference will be taking place next week, Saturday. We have provided free bus. The bus can seat 22. Please, if you are clapping for Jesus, you can do better. We have provided free bus. The bus will leave this place next week, Saturday, by 7 a.m. Please be here. Be here before 7. 7 a.m., the bus will take you there. By 12, the program is over. The bus will also bring you back. When you attend the program, for the first 200 that will attend, there are free gifts for them. Please, we want to encourage all our young adults and youth to please attend. If there are any other announcements, yes, sir. Okay, for ushers, please let me quickly remind the ushers, there will be a training for the ushers from 12. By 12, we would have rounded up. So by 12, there'll be a training, 1 hour training. And that's how we'll be doing trainings for all the workers. Workers in training also, we have started a new class. If you want to be a worker in God's vineyard, just come on Sunday, 7:30. We can still allow you next Sunday. We can allow you. We are graduating the current set. They'll be graduating by the end of July. End of July. So you can quickly join us so that you graduate with them. If there are any other announcements, we'll be informed in the course of the service. No house fellowship today. No house fellowship today. So we are going to be starting with baby dedication. Baby dedication. Yeah. Minister Osana, you come forward now. You give us just one song. This one, introduction. You give us intro. One song while the baby comes forward. The mother of the baby will also dance forward. Those who are trusting God for the fruit of the womb, you join them and celebrate with them. God bless you.
Hallelujah. His fullness, shout hallelujah. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord has made. We will rejoice. We will rejoice and be glad in it. And be glad in it. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh,
this is the day. Hallelujah.
If you are clapping for Jesus, you can do better than that. That is the intro. That is the intro. Please, can we call on all those who are celebrating their birthdays, wedding, anniversary in the month of June? Please also come forward so that we take the prayers together. Those who are celebrating their birthdays in the month of June. Birthdays in the month of June. Please, can you come forward? Come and join the baby. Father, we thank you. We give you glory. If we had enough time, we would have given opportunity for every one of you to sing. But because we have a baby here, mommy, please come. Please stand here. I want people to see you so that they can know that you are now a mommy. Oh, because when people see the way you are dressed, now they will think it's one sister and they'll be doing. Eh? God bless you. I'm going to give you the opportunity of singing one song. Are you ready? Just one song. After that, we pray for your baby. Please let us rejoice with her.
Glory be to the Lord in the highest. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lord in the highest. Hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. For his mercy. Hallelujah. For his protection. Hallelujah. For baby mercy. Hallelujah. Everlasting Father, the King of Glory, we've come to dedicate your daughter unto you. Father, we ask, O God, we have come to return our dear sister Mercy unto you. We ask, Father, that you accept her in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, whatsoever is committed into your hand, you are able to keep until that day. Father, you are the one that has given Mercy to this family as a gift. We have come to return her back to you. We ask that all the days of our life, you will show her the sure mercies of David in Jesus' name. When it is time for her to begin to crawl, that day you will help her. When it is time for her to begin to walk, Father, you will help her. When it's time for her to begin to run, that day you will help her. That day we pray that as she grows up, every need that the parents will have for our upkeep, that day you will provide in Jesus' name. Father, you have called that Mercy. Let that Mercy speak in her favor in Jesus' name. In the morning season, Mercy will speak for her. In the noon, Mercy will speak for her. In the evening, Mercy will speak for her. In the night, Mercy will speak for her. Father, we ask that in the midst of our contemporaries, Daddy, you will set her apart in Jesus' name. Let the Mercy that will speak for her be a generational Mercy in Jesus' name. Mercy, we dedicate you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Begin to make progress in Jesus' name. Begin to go forward in Jesus' name. Your light will not go out in Jesus' name. You will not be cut off in the midst of your days. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Father, we lift up all your children also into your hands. All your children who are celebrating their birthdays or are celebrating their wedding anniversaries. Father, we ask for everyone celebrating birthday in this month of June. They will not be cut off in the midst of their days in Jesus' name. Every appointment with death concerning them in this year, we cancel it in Jesus' name. Father, we ask that as they begin this new journey, Daddy, you will begin to open doors for them in Jesus' name. Let the lines fall for them in pleasant places in Jesus' name. Daddy, we lift up every home that is celebrating their wedding anniversary in this month of June into your hands. Daddy, we pray that you will establish that home in Jesus' name. Every challenge that they are going through in that home, Daddy, turn them to testimony in Jesus' name. You are the author and the creator of the home. We ask that every blessing that you ordained for every home, let it begin to manifest in these homes in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Amen. We can please go back to our seat. Brother Osana David, over to you. The next 30 minutes, please, I want to encourage every one of us to be up on our feet.
next 30 minutes only of Brother Hosanna David, we'll just be praising God. After 30 minutes, we will call you, then we start doing the Thanksgiving. Over to you, sir.
Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
His fullness parish. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't know why you are still sitting down shouting hallelujah to your homemaker. For the Lord who has sustained you from January to June. This is first half of this year. Hallelujah. If you have not heard, sorry, please. Maybe it was a rumor, sir. I've seen on my nails and everything that TB Joshua, Prophet TB Joshua is dead. I wouldn't know if it's a rumor. You heard it as well. Hallelujah. You will not be prophet too. You are just a member, isn't it?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. See, this God has been faithful. Raise your two hands. For the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies, His mercies never come to an end. Lift those hands to Jesus. Say,
they have you every morning.
You every morning.
You every morning.
Great is our faithfulness.
Great is our
faithfulness. Oh, great is our faithfulness. Great is our faithfulness. A cappella. They are new every morning.
They are new every morning.
New every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. I want you to connect. Rabo Shata, lift up your hands, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up. The King of glory is here. Mo yon logo alagbara. Abi ma shonda lewa ya mosu kalawa. Mo yon logo. Jesu. He blessed me there. Memo pe mo le de pe o. Olorun lati January. Mo yan loko. I will worship you forever. Love you forever. I don't know. Because
he's God.
He's true. I will worship you forever. Love you forever. Because this God is so good. I want you to tag this Thanksgiving to something. If you are looking for a child, just tag this Thanksgiving. That by this time, June, your child will be with you, even children. If you don't own a house, by this time, June 2022, you will be a landlord or a landlady. Hallelujah. You carry me when some carry their God to.
Somebody, go and pick a dance partner. Say, have you put the person? You just ask the question. Mommy,
Papa fire me da pila. Say Papa
fire me da pila.
Oh, fire me da pila. Awon mo yobada nigba ti mo do isenda la de mi oruboga 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 nigba ti mo do
As they do me for body. What is Odamilola in English? Kini Odamilola in English.
You prosper me. You flourish me.
Jesus, you love me too much. Oh, too much. Too much. Jesus, you are going to, we are going to go and meet three people. Say, oh, Lord, I'm in Lola. What's your name, Lola? That's number one. Two.
Three.
Oh, damn, Lola.
What's your name, Lola?
Oh, damn, Lola.
What's your name,
Lola?
Oh, damn, Lola. What's
your name, Lola?
Only
Osage.
Osage. Osage. Osage. Osage. Osage.
Osage.
Osage.
Osage. I put you in front of my
love.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
What are you doing?
I am
happy. I you, Baba. As you go, coach, wherever you are, just sit. It is on the floor. As you go, coach, Baba. As you go, coach, Baba. What are you doing?
I am happy.
Oh, if you know this one.
All the children,
all the children,
all the children,
all the children,
all the children,